Boathouse right now, I will tell you that that is probably the most important spot at camp. And the reason it's the most important spot at camp is because our mission is to build girls with courage, confidence, and character to make the better world a better place. And that happens every time you're in a lake at camp. Just last month, I was here with my daughter's brownie troop. And that is our family's fourth generation of Girl Scouts. And I had the opportunity to go out on the lake in a canoe with my youngest daughter. And her entire troop, for the very first time, went on the lake in canoes. They're 7 years old, they're about this tall. And we talk about courage, confidence, and character. Those girls were very nervous. Very, very nervous to go out in the canoe. They were excited, but they were nervous. They didn't have the confidence that they could do it. And they were really, the fear that held them back was, you know, it was normal for their age. It was absolutely normal, what we're very experienced at in Girl Scouting. But what happened is slowly, one of them walked forward, and the next one walked forward, and the first couple of canoes went out with the brownies. And they came back out of those canoes, and they still a little taller, because they had gained some confidence that they didn't have even a half hour before they'd been on the lake. They were more courageous, because they had absolutely succeeded in something so important. And because of the teamwork that they got through, you know, two girls in a canoe, that's tough stuff. Because, you know, you can go in circles for a long time and not actually go anywhere. But you have to get back to the dock. You have to get back to the dock. And that requires teamwork, which builds character. So the boathouse that we're dedicating today just is magnificent. A magnificent gift to our camp. And I cannot thank you enough for that gift to this beautiful camp that is so important to me personally, but so important to our council. But also for that gift that you gave me to have that opportunity with my daughter is a true treat that I can thank you for so very much. Now, I have had the pleasure of talking with you a couple of times, and I think everyone else here deserves that same treat. So I'll make one for her if she doesn't find it. But would you like to share a little bit about why this is so important to you?
Well, when we had like the promise after the promise, we always sang, make new friends. So I was told not to talk too much. So I think this campsite is beautiful. We have them too in New York, but we don't have the grounds like you have. And most of the time they are donated by people. So we had one, it was called, what was it again, I forget?
Merrywood.
The Merrywood. Everybody loved that name. But Mr. Kaufman came around and he gave the Girl Scouts more money and it became the Kaufman Camp. So that was it. The girls got used to the name and we had wonderful times there. Even in the winter time I brought them there. And I even took the juniors. I had a junior troop first. And like everybody else gets involved when you have children and they come home and say, Mommy, I want to bring you a brownie. I wear a brown uniform and go on trips. Okay. That night, this leader called me up and she said, oh, Mrs. Carroll, your daughter wants to be a brownie. I said, right. What could you do for this troop? We get a lot of girls, but never leaders. I said, I never knew anything about Girl Scouts. I never heard it on the radio. There was none in my neighborhood. My father and mother had a business. We were all helping there, so I didn't know anything about it. So I said, well, I don't think so. I got a boy that's 2 years younger than my daughter. Where am I going to put him? Oh, bring him to the meeting. You think he's going to stay in the meeting? Oh, okay. So anyway, I went to the leaders group. And before I knew it, when September came along of that year, I became a junior. And I was there for quite a year, because I had 50 years in it. I was there maybe about the same amount, 20 years or so. I took them to Washington, D.C. I took them to Irving Berlin's parade on Fifth Avenue when he was 100 years old. And when Mrs. Berlin always came to the Greater New York office, she always brought a bouquet of tulips. You knew right away she was visiting Girl Scouts with those tulips. A very, very nice lady, very nice. So I had my good times, very good times, and I think I'll cut it short now. About our
hear more stories.
Yes.
And I was looking at my mom as I was listening to your stories and making eye contact with her, kind of as we were reminiscing. And Oma, what I learned today in this very room that I will always then have to dedicate to you, I did not know till today that my grandma was my mom's Girl Scout leader, and she was a junior leader too. So there you go. So we've got a little bit, and so I will always remember learning that piece of information at your dedication. And so I wanted to say thank you on behalf of big girls and new Girl Scouts, all the girls, and we never leave Girl Scouts apparently ever, do we? And so thank you for helping us to continue an opportunity to, as Tracy said, grow girls of courage, confidence, and character. I remember my first experiences with camp, and you loved camp, and you and I shared that you lived in a kind of a camp that grew up into a community. So we too cherish our community and cherish whatever your kids told you to not do, don't listen to them.
We have some daisies for you. Might need on your trek down to the